Job, chapter 1. In the land of Uz, there lived a man whose name was Job. This man was blameless and upright. He feared God and shunned evil. He had 7 sons and 3 daughters, and he owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, and 500 donkeys, and had a large number of servants. He was the greatest man among all the people of the East. His sons used to take turns holding feasts in their homes, and they would invite their 3 sisters to eat and drink with them. When a period of feasting had run its course, Job would send and have them purified. Early in the morning, he would sacrifice a burnt offering for each of them, thinking,
"Perhaps my children have sinned and cursed God in their hearts."
This was Job's regular custom. One day, the angels came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came with them. The Lord said to Satan,
"Where have you come from?"
Satan answered the Lord,
"From roaming the earth and going back and forth in it."
Then the Lord said to Satan,
"Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil."
"Does Job fear God for nothing?"
Satan replied.
"Have you not put a hedge around him and his household and everything he has? You have blessed the work of his hands so that his flocks and herds are spread throughout the land. But stretch out your hand and strike everything he has, and he will surely curse you to your face."
The Lord said to Satan,
"Very well, then, everything he has is in your hands, but on the man himself do not lay a finger."
Then Satan went out from the presence of the Lord. One day when Job's sons and daughters were feasting and drinking wine at the oldest brother's house, a messenger came to Job and said,
"The oxen were plowing and the donkeys were grazing nearby, and the Sabaeans attacked and carried them off. They put the servants to the sword, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you."
While he was still speaking, another messenger came and said,
"The fire of God fell from the sky and burned up the sheep and the servants, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you."
While he was still speaking, another messenger came and said,
"The Chaldeans formed 3 raiding parties and swept down on your camels and carried them off. They put the servants to the sword, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you."
While he was still speaking, yet another messenger came and said,
"Your sons and daughters were feasting and drinking wine at the oldest brother's house, when suddenly a mighty wind swept in from the desert and struck the 4 corners of the house. It collapsed on them, and they are dead, and I am the only one who has escaped to tell you."
At this, Job got up and tore his robe and shaved his head. Then he fell to the ground in worship and said,
"Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked I will depart. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised."
In all this, Job did not sin by charging God with wrongdoing.